that sugar sweet. Don't let nobody touch it unless that somebody's me. I gotta be a man, there ain't no other way. Cause girl, you're hotter than a Southern California day. I don't wanna play no games, you gotta be afraid. Don't give me all that shy shit, no makeup on, that's my sugar.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. On behalf of Aisha and Murat, I would like to extend a warm springtime welcome to this very special gathering of love and friendship between two people and their family and friends. We come together in the spirit of God's love and hope as privileged witnesses to share in the joy, celebration, and union of their lives. Marriage is a promise made in the hearts of two people who love each other that takes a lifetime to fulfill. Within the circle of its love, marriage encompasses all of life's most important relationships. A wife and a husband are each other's lover, teacher, confidant, listener, critic, and best friend. It is into this relationship that you both have chosen to enter. Aisha and Murat met each other about 6 years ago through Murat's cousin, Baris, and Aisha's friend, Yasmin. They immediately saw something very special in one another as they were attracted to each other's warm and fun personalities. Over the months and years that followed, the relationship grew closer with more care, trust, and confidence, allowing them to learn much about each other's personalities, their likes and dislikes, what made them smile, and what challenged them. For their engagement on February 17th, 2014, which happened to be their 5-year anniversary, by the way, here's a little story. Murat had his wonderfully romantic dinner all planned out and was going to surprise Aisha after dinner. When she had asked him whether she should work or if he had anything planned for their anniversary, he nonchalantly told her to work. Smart. But that she should leave early as he had a small dinner planned. His intention was to make her believe that nothing special was planned. Well, his plan backfired. And as luck would have it, Aisha got stuck at work that evening. Murat had to regroup and finally got the opportunity to propose on their anniversary just before midnight at home. And as we all know, she said yes. Their engagement was the next natural step in their relationship, and they're here today to formalize their lifelong commitment in marriage before all of you, their closest family and friends. If you want to hand off your flowers so you can hold hands. Aisha and Murat, now is the time which you have chosen to become husband and wife. We are here not only to witness your commitment to each other, but to celebrate the love and trust you have found for each other. You both know that you must communicate with each other and be open to communication, which I'm sure you also understand is a lot harder than it sounds. Words must be said softly and listened to carefully. As you all know, their lighthearted, generous, and happy personalities are infectious, allowing everyone around them to feel welcomed and loved. As family and friends, you all form the community of support that surrounds this special couple. Each of you, by your presence here today, is being called upon to uphold them in honoring and loving each other. Always stand beside them, never between them. Offer them your love and support, not your judgment. Encourage them with your kindness and loving hearts and honor this marriage into which they have come to be joined here today. Murat and Aisha wish to take a special moment to remember those family members and friends who are not with them here today, especially Murat's grandfathers, Ali and Jamal, and Aisha's grandparents, Mehmet, Risa, Hatice, and Rukuye. They are all deeply loved, missed, and will always be in their hearts and minds. May the memories of their legacies and spiritual presence here today and always continue to influence Murat and Aisha's lives, providing love, strength, and courage to be the best person they can be. Aisha and Murat also feel very strongly that the years of unconditional love, affection, and encouragement given to them by their wonderful mothers, Hafize and Sirma, have helped to shape their lives into the loving, compassionate, and thoughtful individuals they have become today. In a simple and heartfelt expression of their appreciation for their mother's wisdom, guidance, and support, both would like to offer a symbolic gift of beauty and gratitude to the women who have greatly influenced their lives. Please go right ahead. And now, real and true, the most important thing in our lives. For love is the creator of our favorite memories and the foundation of our fondest dreams. Without love, we merely exist, but with love, we truly begin to live. This first reading is called The Key to Love. The key to love is understanding, as it is the little things that say so much by themselves. The key to love is forgiveness, to accept each other's faults and pardon mistakes. The key to love is sharing and facing your good fortunes as well as the bad together, but conquering problems, forever searching for ways to intensify your happiness. The key to love is giving without thought of return, but with the hope of just a simple smile, and by giving in, but never giving up. The key to love is respect. Respect, realizing that you are two separate people with different ideas, that you don't belong to each other, that you belong with each other, and share a mutual bond. The key to love is inside us all. It takes time and patience to unlock all the ingredients that will take you to its threshold. It is the continual learning process that demands a lot of work, but the rewards are more than worth the effort, and that is the key to love. Now, as you acknowledge your intentions of marriage, know that with your family there will never be a shortage of love and dedication to your happiness. And between the two of you, we pray that from this moment on, your lives are full of love and joy, companionship, support, loving acceptance, and gentle compassion. As witnesses to a marriage, we need to know that you are indeed committed to entering into such a relationship. And by affirming your intentions before the love and support of your family and friends, you will express that commitment. So I ask you, Murat, will you take this woman to be your wife, that you may live together in the bond of marriage? Do you promise to love and honor her, comfort her, and be faithful to her so long as you both shall live?
I do.
He said, I do, if you didn't hear that. Aishay, will you take this man to be your husband, that you may live together in the bond of marriage? Do you promise to love and honor him, comfort him, and be faithful to him so long as you both shall live?
I do.
A little suspense there. This next reading is called The Blessing of the Hands. As you tenderly hold each other's hands, see the gift that they are to you. These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours on your wedding day, as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch, will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief fills your mind. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children. These are the hands that will help you to hold your family as one. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it. And lastly, these are the hands that, even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you that same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. Well, before you are joined in marriage, I must remind you both of the solemn and firm nature of the relationship into which you're about to enter. The vows of marriage that you share are meant to convey a true and intimate expression of your love and commitment for each other. So, Murat, if you can repeat after me, please. I, Murat, take you, Aishay, to be my wife. To have and to hold from this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health, to love and cherish as long as we both shall live. I, Aishay, take you, Murat, to be my husband. To have and to hold from this day forward. It's okay. To have and to hold from this day forward. For better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and cherish as long as we both shall live. So take a deep breath after that. That was nice. For thousands of years, lovers have exchanged rings as a token of their love and commitment. People often talk about the wedding bands being a perfect circle with no beginning and no end. But we all know that these rings do have a beginning. Rock is dug up from the earth. Metal is liquefied in a furnace at 1,000 degrees, then molded, cooled, and painstakingly polished. Something beautiful is made from raw elements. Love is like that. It's hot, dirty work. It comes from humble beginnings and is made by imperfect beings. It is the process of making something beautiful where there was once nothing at all. And may these rings remind you of the unending spirit of your love and commitment. So, gentlemen, present the rings. Okay, Marat, place it on her left hand. Repeat after me. Aisha, please accept this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. I give you this ring as a symbol of my constant love and devotion, which I pledge to you today and all the days of my life. Good. Left hand there. Marat, please accept this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. I give you this ring as a symbol of my constant love and devotion, which I pledge to you today and all the days of my life. All right, fits nicely. You are two lives. Two people so very different, yet so similar. Together, you now stand as one, ready to share your future as it comes. Remember that honesty and kindness are fruits of love, and with care and trust, the best is yet to be revealed. As Aisha and Marat begin their new life together, we pray that God will watch over and walk beside them to keep them safe, healthy, and happy. And now, for as much as you both have consented together in the bond of marriage, before your family and friends, it is my pleasure and privilege to pronounce you husband and wife. Congratulations, and a kiss for God. Face your guests. I introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Marat and Aisha Kochak.
Yeah. Yeah. It's my lifesaver right now. As her maid of honor, I'm so proud to be here tonight next to her. Yes, I heard a good speech is like a miniskirt. It has to be short enough to keep it interesting and long enough to cover essentials. And I know best speech makers follow three simple rules. Stand up, speak up, and quickly shut up. And I'm really not sure if I can stick to these rules, but I'll try my best. But who cares about the rules, right? So Aisha and I have been friends for a little over 17 years now. Wow. So when you look at my beautiful friend, you can tell that we met on when we were on third grade, right? You don't believe me? I said not looking at me, looking at her. So, anyway, I just wanna, you know, pass this subject because it annoys me. I really do wanna enjoy my night tonight. Now, if I start telling you all the good and bad memories we had, so the whole wedding is all about her and I, and we don't want that, right? So in all those special years, we had such special moments. And we cried together, we laughed together, and there are many things only you and I find funny, right? You know, all we do is like look at each other and start laughing, right? So, and I exactly can tell how she thinks or how she feels by just looking at her. So no words necessary. So at this point, I kind of feel obligated to give Murat a little hint about their happiness for the rest of their life. So Murat, so I know you got to know a little bit about Aisha after 6.5 years, right? You do, okay. But there's one thing I need you to know, that it doesn't matter how often you change your job, you're gonna end up with the same boss, right? So no surprises here, we all know that, right? And Murat, I know you really like to take care about your body, your health, you know, by working out regularly, having a healthy diet. But do you really think Aisha cares about how great six packs you have? Do you? Okay, so I have an advice for you. So instead, I urge you to consider about your neck health, okay? So you should be able to move your neck up and down all the time, all right? So that's very important. So twice a day, 18 times a day, okay? So up and down by saying, yes, honey, okay? So when you both are in a fight, okay? It's very important. So, and you'll be the best looking man ever in her eyes. So, well, wait, and I hope you realize how lucky you are by getting married with a Turkish woman, right? Okay? I know. So, I know you know how good cook she is, right? And there's one thing you really should appreciate, that you don't have to pray after you eat. And this is a big plus. So, I always knew how great a couple you both can make. But come on, Murat, it took you really 5 years to propose her? Look at my friend's beauty. So did really had to do all the conversation over and over, you know? You know how many hours you stole from my life? So after every conversation, I never did and I couldn't, but I always wanted to tell you, listen to this. Out of the sleep, she got the thoughts on her mind she can believe, and she can't take it no more. She's been years, and she has everything you want, where's her ring? 'Cause she's ready, yeah. Murat, you're the one she want to marry, and if you want her, boy, got her. There's nothing, no, no, she wouldn't do. She wouldn't do just to get up next to you. Murat, you're the one she wants to marry. And if you want her, boy, you got her. There's nothing, no, no, she wouldn't do. She wouldn't do just to give a baby you. And just the thought of rain gets her so high, so high. And just the thought of rain gives her so high, so high. Okay. But, of course, there's one thing we always forget, that Murat is an engineer. And everything has to be on a perfect timing and in order, right? Okay. So finally that night, after midnight, so my phone rang like happily. So it's, you know, the happiest person ever on the other side of the line telling me that he finally proposed her. And I think I was happier for myself that we don't have to do the same conversation ever again. I'm just kidding. So I was so happy with her. So I got so emotional that night. I thought about both of them, and I'm like, okay, so finally they're getting married. And so this emotion took me to our college years. So I thought about like how innocent kids we were, right? Like comparing to nowadays kids. And so have you ever seen a college student like knitting on a college's cafeteria? I don't think so. So it was us actually. Like we were ignoring all the weird stares on us. We were happily just knitting, Aisha and I, right? So we were crazy, but we were just so happy. You know, our happiest moments are getting together with friends, singing and dancing. And when we got the blues, you know, if we were lucky, our drug was just a bottle of beer, right? And singing again. So the life was really, really so good back then, but the happiest moments for you both, now and ahead of you. Aisha, you're more than a friend for me. You know that. Even though we can't get along sometimes, but what we know is we feel like sisters. I can't tell you how happy I'm for you finding your true love. And you deserve it. I really, truly believe that. And Murat, I know you'll be a great husband, a friend, a lover, a great father to your kids. But I really have no worries about my friend as long as you're around her. So, and please accept this little advice from me. So no matter how hard the life is or can be, you two always try to make each other smile, feel loved, and feel special. And always, you know, never stop searching to satisfy each other. So thank you everyone coming and sharing these special moments with us. So, and I would like to... And I just would like to add, I know it took me forever, I wasn't really stick to those rules, but I want to add like some words in Turkish. Merhaba, benim adım Mine, Ayşe ile ben 17 senedir arkadaşız. Üniversiteden beri, Türkiye'den. Ve biz hala birbirimize kenetli olarak burada kardeş gibiyiz. Birlikte, her şeyimizi birlikte yapıyoruz. Bizim Ayşe ile çok özel anlarımız oldu. Yani bunları kelimelerle anlatmak mümkün değil şu anda. Birlikte ağladık, birlikte güldük. Yani o benim için çok özel. O benim artık kardeşim gibi burada. Ve ben onun için o kadar mutluyum ki. Ve Ayşe'nin gerçekten gerçek aşkı bulduğuna inanıyorum Murat'la. Ve onların hayat boyunca çok mutlu olduklarına inanıyorum. Ama ne çektim be. 5 sene ya, 5 sene ne çektim be. Okay. So. Bitti. Okay. Now let's cheers to this beautiful couple. May the joys you share tonight be the beginning of a lifetime of great happiness. I love you both, guys. Cheers, guys.
Ladies and gentlemen, family of the bride, family of the groom, friends, Stephen's crew in the back there, can't forget you guys. Welcome. A lot of work has been put into this wedding in the last few months. I just want to say, let's give a round of applause to the bride and groom, please. To Mr. and Mrs. Kolchak. I'm gonna start off with a little sentiment. As an only child back in Trinidad, I didn't have any siblings. And when I moved here from Trinidad when I was 17, I was alone in a new country, new city. I didn't know anyone. First day I met Mo, I met Bill, and I met T.I., who isn't here. They quickly became my family, my brothers. And I'm happy to be here, Mo. You honor me to be up here today. And a lot of you Stevens crew know that I had a fresh off the boat mustache and a Trini accent.
Still do.
A little bit, yeah. First week of college, I met these guys, and they became my brothers. For 14 years, I've known these guys, half of my life. And you know what? Half of my stories today has Mo in it. That says a lot. That says a lot. He's a quintessential friend. He's loyal, he's honest, and he will always have your back, no matter what. He's been there for me for 14 years. Now, a day doesn't go by that he hasn't been there for me. We're more than friends, we're brothers. We have memories, we have experiences, we've shared so much together. And you know what? He taught me how to shave. I think I was 18 or 19 that I saw him in his dorm room without any shaving cream, without any water, just going at it, making himself bloodied in his dorm room. And I was like, what the hell are you doing? But you know what? I asked him to help me shave because he had the most experience I knew. This guy will get a 5 o'clock shadow an hour after his initial shave. Mo's loved by everyone. I don't know a single person that has said a bad thing about him in the last 14 years. And you know what? We're all here to celebrate his wedding, but I also want to say thank you to both of you. You've been there for me for 14 years, and I can never forget that. I don't have any family here, except for my fiance now. But you two have always been there for me. And one day I hope our kids become friends as much as we are. All right, I'm gonna wrap this up. Enough about the sentiments. A couple more things. Mo's asked me to refrain from any sensitive topics, such as ex-girlfriends. So that cuts my speech in about 4 seconds. Mo, your level of domesticity now has to greatly improve. You need to learn how to do dishes. You need to learn how to do laundry. I'll help you this time. We'll find out what the perm cycle really means. And remember, women are meant to be loved, not understood. All right? But someone told me a while back that magic only happens at the most unexpected times, and I agree and I disagree. I've known Mo for 14 years, and he loves this girl. And I know you do. And Aisha, I know you found the man that you want to be with for the rest of your life and start a family with as well. This love that you have isn't simple. You always will fight and disagree, but as long as you love each other and know that you will never quit on each other, this magic will never die. So everyone, join me in a toast to congratulate these two, to wish them the best, and all the love and happiness in this world.
Ladies and gents, before I start, I want to point out to our beautiful bride, Aisha, you look stunning tonight. Mo, you're all right. Mo, I want to thank you for including me in part of your wedding. I'm so honored to be standing here as one of your best men. I also want to say, next time you're doing this, I hope I'm included as well. Ladies and gents, if you don't know me, my name is Shaq. And I love you too. Before I got up here, Mo asked me not to talk about any of his exes. So that cut my speech about 35 minutes. So all this, can't use them anymore. I like to believe that everybody one day will meet a person they're gonna love, cherish, and admire for the rest of their lives. Luckily for Mo, that moment happened about 9 years ago when he met me. I met Mo about 9 years ago when we both went to Stevens. And we've been through so much together that I'm lucky so much today standing here calling one of my closest friends. So ladies and gents, raise your glasses. Join me in a toast to the beautiful bride and the groom. Cheers, guys. Here's my brother, Bill.
So I want to get the awkward part out of the way. I'm sure you're all wondering who invited the white guy to the wedding. And I just wanted to assure you, no one is crashing this wedding. Because Vince Vaughn is not an engineer because we don't have enough charm. So now, after my poor attempt at humor, let me introduce myself. My name is Bill, and I've been close friends with Murat since our first year of college in 2002. I remember the days and weeks leading up to my departure to college, and I was filled with anxiety and real sadness because I grew up in a close family, and the thought of leaving them really broke my heart. So when my parents' minivan pulled away from campus, and I was alone for the first time in 17 years of my life without the support structure that had guided me for the previous 17. I walked up the 5 floors in our residence hall thinking that I was the unluckiest guy in the world because I was on the 5th floor of a residence hall with no elevator. Little did I know that I would meet some of the best friends in my entire life. All of us on that floor would join the same fraternity, and it was in that group I met my best friend, Murat. I remember the first day that we really bonded. Your dad had just dropped off your futon, and a group of us wandered into your room. We sat down and we started putting the futon together piece by piece. And once it was finally finished, your roommate, Brian Bokel, walked in and just plopped right on it and said, "Mo, thank your dad for the futon." From there, Murat and I would partner up on our first college project, which was designing a chair. It was the worst statics problem that I think I ever did. And I remember being sad because Murat told me at that time that he was an electrical engineering major. And I remember at that time I wished that he would have rethought his thinking. And at some point later in freshman year, he started talking to me about switching to mechanical engineering, which of course I said was a great idea. From that moment forward, we were inseparable around campus. And I just want to let you know, Aisha, that there were a lot of jokes that me and Murat were married. But thankfully, it was illegal at the time. So if you really screw this up, Mo, you could be a bride for one time in your life. I believe the reason that I gravitated to Murat above everyone else at campus because of the warmth of your spirit, Mo. You always had a smile on your face, and the joy of your spirit was intoxicating. Beneath the warm exterior, you shared a love of family with me. You talked about your mom, your dad, Jeanette, Jimmy, and Tommy all the time, and I was not surprised when you bought the house right next door. Besides all those wonderful traits, Murat, it was the empathy for those around you that was always focused on their happiness. It really touched me. So when graduation was approaching, it was like deja vu for me all again. Because those same feelings I had when I was leaving for college came right back. Because in the 5 years of school, we had created our own family unit. You were always at the center of everything, Mo. Everybody gravitated to you. All the friends and my closest friends are because of you. So leaving New Jersey for Connecticut was frightening, and not just because of how boring Connecticut is. I did leave for Connecticut, and you came to visit me frequently, and you mentioned a phrase that I will never forget. We were driving in the rain, and you told me, Bill, you know how I know who close friends are? It's when you haven't seen them in a long time, and you know that nothing has changed the first time you see them. I remember that night because that's the first time you mentioned marrying Aisha and thinking about proposing. Aisha, you're creating a great partner in life. He's kind, loyal to the ones he loves. You're such a lucky girl, and I'm so happy that Murat found a soul equally as exquisite as his own. Murat, you're starting your own family, and I know you are nervous about the future, but I just want you to know nothing has changed in our friendship in 13 years. Life changes and we meet new people along the way who add to the experience, but I can't think of a better partner than the beautiful woman who is sitting right beside you to share it.
Oh, that's beautiful, man.
You both share so many endearing traits that drew me to you in the first place, and I just wanted to say I love you guys and I can't wait to share our future together.
Thank you. Thank you. Çok seviyorum.